Right, here we go. If anybody happens to pop in, let me know my levels, because I don't know what I'm doing. Trying to organize my screens is the worst. Hang on. Hello, Harkness. It's washing time. Go back to class! Can you hear me? How are my sound levels? Hey Jay. So I'm not looking up constantly. Can you guys hear me at all? Is my music too loud? Funny that for you the HTML5 player messes up, but for me the HTML5 player is like way better, but not. How are my levels? Because it's hard for me to check without echoing. One sprite animation, like he has like an idol and like him spitting and turning into a ball. It's kind of like he's. I have only one reference picture of him, and it's his idol sprite because nobody likes this character. However, that does mean I can take a lot of like liberties with actually drawing him, so it's kind of. I tend to leave the voice a little on the soft side, just because, I mean, it's actually kind of, that's fully up to Max. I don't like to put the mic too close to my face because I tend to breathe kind of loud, so yeah. I just want to kind of avoid breathing into people's ears. I don't know what to do with, every time I think I've got like a pose for this thing, it's kind of like this is kind of like this thing down here. It's sort of like a second right here. Then all of my stuff is just gonna be like metal remixes right now. You say least favorite, like, I don't like it, it's just... I should actually turn my phone off right now. Thank you. Pig's anatomy is really hard to pin down because of this ridiculous, like, random human kind of growing out of his tail thing. One of those mysterious design choices that I do kind of wish had a bit more of an explanation. I may have to scratch this entire sketch, because I don't know exactly how to pose this character. There's not much to work with. But... There will be a lot of Undertale music in here, by the way, because... letting people know. For, like, context, this is what I'm drawing. This thing right here. That's the only reference I have of this character. Oh god, I'm just... Everything is going crazy! Hang on! Give me a sec. Where are my windows? My windows have disappeared. There we go. Well, I kind of have a basis there, so I'll probably go ahead and... I forget how to use my own program so often. Why is this still here? This there we go. There's it vertically again. Oh, and I'm actually kind of thrilled that there's not that much art for this character, because then I can do whatever the hell I want. Delete all the wings and start from scratch. Damn, I can English real well. My English is amazing. Okay, well, no. Ooh, transform. Thank you. Oh, yay. I'm so intelligent. God. Maybe I should keep it together. Blocking the shapes more, like, better this time. I don't flip my pictures nearly as often as I should, but this one just looked off to begin with, so it was kind of inevitable. No, Monty on the Run is not in the metal remixes. I never found a good one. I haven't really been keeping this list up to date, so it's mostly gonna be Rich at Eevee. It's like Undertale stuff and Toho. As I kind of mentioned in my little bio thing below, I would be listening to Guilty Gear music because it would be thematic, but Arc System has a bit of an issue with people playing their music for things, so I'd rather not, like, have to deal with that. I've mostly just been talking about the fact that I don't have that much music on this playlist. Oh god, the sniffles. They're coming for me. Damn it. Hang on. Okay. Alright. I think we're safe to start zooming in and actually. Look how much of a cluster this is. Zoom in, oh my god. Well. No, well, okay, the intro to the song, like, before he breaks the button, is called King Under the Mountain or whatever. This song is just called Asgore, so, like, the main part of his theme is just called Asgore. There's a joke among people who, like, are familiar with the, because if you look at a lot of the song titles for this, like, a lot of the song titles are really, like, I don't know, cheesy? So, one of the jokes is that Asgore is actually the one naming the soundtrack, because he's the king who's notoriously bad with names. So his own theme is just his own name, so people make that joke, and I think it's funny. That's I ascribe to that headcanon. I can zoom this. No, I can. Wow, that just makes it all pixely and grosser. That's great. Even harder for me to use this as a reference. Just put this window away. Nobody else is joining. There's no point for me putting up my viewer list. Alright. And because it's Richard Avey, he put Dog Song after it because, you know, why enjoy your good remix in video form? Okay. Technically, I should be doing this at such a large resolution that I can work at, like, full size and not, like, 200%, but whatever. Why am I under lighter pencil? Darker pencil. There you go. You have to fix this face. It's beautiful. Just kidding. He's got like gnarly, really gnarly teeth. Should kind of. Because they're like all sharp and shit in the back, but then like in the front they're like humanish teeth. In a good way, of course. Thank you. I did kind of mess up in the script. It's hard to unhear the lyrics to that song once you hear them. Sorry, dude, you have a hard face to draw. Thanks, Harpus. Like patience with details, though, and here's the truth for why I put a lot of detail. Detail is my way of masking that I don't know what I'm doing. Like, distract them with details. Scribble stuff all over it, make people not realize that I don't know how to art. Like, the right way. I mean, I know how to art, I just don't know how to do it the quote-unquote right way. Maybe I do know what I'm doing, I'm just too lazy. I'm too lazy to do it the right way, so I do it the harder way. This is actually what I do at work, and it pisses my like managers off, but I get the work done. It's like I work hard, not smart. Completely unfitting music. Best music for drawing, like, things. In gear defenses, I'm pretty sure most pure gears are always angry. Like, the only two gears that I know that aren't super angry all the time are only, like, half and fourth, respectively. And that those being Dizzy and, Sin. I guess Kai counts, too, now that he's part gear. Spoilers. Thank you. Oh, true. That's right. Yeah, Paradigm. He's not angry. Paradigm is not angry. He is the broest. He is the broest non-human gear. Actually, if I look at this sprite, this storm actually goes above that one, which is weird. Huh. Gear anatomy, because it wasn't weird enough. So I was like thinking, well, Bronze's design is really, like, freaky. And it's like, no, actually, she's pretty tame. The glasses weren't enough for Paradigm. They had to give him, like, a cap, too. And people still call him a bird. Well, Soul still calls him a bird. Yeah, no, it's, yeah, it is a graduate cap. It's like, why? Let's give him glasses! Look, he looks smart now! Oh yeah! Wait, let's give him more glasses! He needs all the glasses! Yeah! Gig is smart now! Make them shaded glasses, and now he's all like, deal with it. Probably shouldn't be doing this, because then I won't be able to undo out of it. Deal with it! Deal with it, I'm Gig. Alright, let's back out of that. She messed up his teeth. I should probably fix them so that they're in proportion. There we go. Using the thing for Bronze, the little Brontopod sprite thing, like inadvertently gave her a lot of traits common with existing gears, which is really lucky, I guess. In terms of, I don't even know why I decided to choose the Brontopod for Bronze's design. It just happened. Like, it just seemed like a good idea at the time. Mm-hmm. Whatever those guys are doing outside is really loud. I hope the mic isn't kicking it up. I think they're trying to drain the lake outside. We have a parking lot like drainage issue problem, and whenever it rains heavily, it just floods and turns into like a small lake. I think they're trying to figure out how to get it to drain permanently, but every time they try, they fail. Hard to figure out what's going on in the back because of the way the sprite is designed. So I'm kind of glad that I'm covering most of this area up with this hand. up, you should have every major tech. No, just kidding. I don't know. I mean, how many? I would say at least one of every, like, non-unique enemy. Like, if you're planning on having, like, certain rare enemies, then don't show those off because they're gonna be special and, like, what the hell. But if you're just gonna show off, like, just try to show, like, one of every basic enemy that is guaranteed to show up. Your brain is slowly turning to mush. My legs are slowly turning to mush. This is not a comfortable seat to sit in. And draw for long periods of time. The humanoid figure under Gig is in fact female because boobies, but the face is actually like it's actually kind of masculine on the sprite. Of course, there's not much to go off on the sprite, which is really like why it's sort of frustrating. So that's why I'm having kind of a hard time on the female on this face here. I mean, it's just kind of like. It's actually, honestly, probably, like, androgynous, but boobs, so female, quote-unquote, triggered. I don't know. who knows, maybe it's not female, maybe they just didn't sprite chest well and made it look like boobs when it wasn't supposed to be. Gig itself is referred to as male, from what I hear, because I didn't play the game myself. I mean, I didn't, I don't think I had a DS at the time. And even if I did, it was kind of not a great game, but I don't know. I'm just going to play the androgynous card here, because there's not much official work to kind of work off of. You know what? I should probably save. I don't think I've saved this entire time. Here we go. Oh, don't crash on me now. For 2 years. Are you being difficult? Seriously. Oh god, I can't do this. Fine. We'll do it the hard way. Actually not looking too bad so far. It's just a weird design to begin with. Thank you. go. Saved. Start for reals now. An hour and a half just to get the sketch done. Progress. Oops. Did I put that on the wrong way? I put that on the wrong way. Now the fun part. Faking a bunch of detail. Thank you. This is a Super Metroid guitar medley by Family Jewels 7X on YouTube. And in case that didn't get through, I'll just type it. That I look at it, I don't think he has these stripy things on his shoulders. Well. Not sure why Gig is doing this. Welcome back. Why Gig is doing that thing with his hands, but it's like one of the only distinguishing characteristics, I suppose. He has no lines, he just growls and stuff, so I don't know. I wouldn't know. Never seen Dragon.
What's up, guys? Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks so much to my man Henry for requesting this awesome song for me to cover. If you guys are digging the music and you want to support me, as well as get some cool stuff like tabs, backing tracks, and choosing what song I cover next, hit that support button. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week with a new cover.
Oh yeah, more unfitting music. Yeah, I hear Trigun's pretty good. It's just, it was one of those that was kind of never like a really high priority given what I've heard. It just, it seemed kind of generic, but you know, who knows? I mean, I shouldn't talk doing gigs with you. every anime trope ever. This arm seems a little too long, but you know what? I don't care. At this point, this anatomy is already so screwed up, I don't think. Gig sure works out. Okay. Okay. This was from like the XX era. Sort of, like it was a little bit after XX. This is just how the designers draw things. They put lots of muscles on everything. The character that got me into Guilty Gear, I'm making a lot of hand motions as if you can see. The character that got me into Guilty Gear, Zappa. Holy cow, his whole joke is that he's supposed to be like a regular old, like just a really regular run-of-the-mill dude who just happens to be possessed by like a ton of ghosts that make him do crazy things. He was a normal average Joe. He was muscular as hell. I mean, it was kind of like a point of design contention because people were like, wow, he's really ripped for like an average Joe. And that became sort of like the norm of his design, but then Exert came along and they like took away his muscles and everybody was sad. But it makes more sense now. But yeah, I mean, that's just kind of what they did. They put muscles on anything that was supposed to be remotely masculine. So just smile and nod. Smile and nod. You're linking stuff in chat and you're making me have to actually go and click things. See, that's what he looks like now. I mean, not super, like, totally what he looks like now, because those are, like, colors from his, like, that was, like, a concept color for his, for, like, the Gashapon machine thing, because, not Gashapon, that thing, Pachinko. That was his, like, a concept of the design for his, like, Pachinko debut thing. No, okay. I still feel like some of the muscular is still there, but not sure. Okay, so, like, his final in Revelator is still, I mean, he still has a little bit of toning, but the clothing mostly covers it up. What I'm talking about is, hang on, I'm going to link this in chat because come on, load. Okay, you have seen it. Okay, good. Because, holy shit. but yeah, no, he doesn't have like a lot of but it's not what he was. It's just, yeah. I digress. Let me go back to Trunk. Yeah, this arm is really wonky and bendy looking. I'm not sure if I'll keep it like that, but I don't know. It's so inhuman that it doesn't matter. Kind of matches the sprite, honestly. The sprites are kind of noodly armed. I mean, you say that this guy, This guy works out. Look at Bronze. Bronze is super muscular. She's just,